Hi everyone, welcome to the world of GK for learning general knowledge. Today, let's study a new topic from the Indian Constitution, that is, the schedules of the Constitution. I am going to share an interesting quote to remember all the 12 schedules of the Constitution. These schedules are very important and repeatedly asked in every examinations. So, listen carefully. I will ask some questions at the end. Let's start. Schedules of Indian Constitution. Here is our quote, Tears of Old PM. Here, T indicates territories, E emoluments, A affirmation, R Rajya Sabha, S scheduled areas, O other areas, F Federal system, O official languages, L land reforms, D defection, P panchayats, and M municipalities. Now let's see one by one. First schedule. Here I am writing the code words. First schedule, territories. So, first schedule consists of name of the states, territorial jurisdiction, union territories, and their extent. Name of the states, territorial jurisdiction, and union territories, and their extent, everything comes under schedule first. Second schedule, keyword is emolument. From emolument, we'll get the first letter E, that is, that we are taken here. Tears of old PM, E is the first letter of emolument. So, emolument means salary, or that second schedule consists of salary, allowance, privileges, etc. of president, vice president, prime minister, MPs, judges of high court, supreme court, CAG, etc. And third schedule. Third schedule is affirmation. Affirmation, here A means affirmation. Affirmation is nothing but oath of union ministers, members of parliament, judges of high court, supreme court, state ministers, CAG. CAG means comptroller and auditor general, and candidates for election, etc. So, affirmation of all these members comes under schedule third. Next one is schedule fourth, Rajya Sabha. Allocation of seats in the Rajya Sabha to the states and union territories. So, allocation of seats in the Rajya Sabha to the states and to the union territories, that comes under schedule fourth. Fifth schedule, scheduled areas. Provisions relating to the administration and control of scheduled areas and scheduled tribes. Schedule 5 deals with the provisions relating to the administration and control of scheduled areas and scheduled tribes. Next one is scheduled 6. Schedule 6. Other areas. Provisions relating to the administration of tribal areas in the state of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, and Mizoram. So, other areas means the provisions relating to the administration of tribal areas in these four states. The four states are Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, and Mizoram. Schedule 7, Federal System. Federal system is nothing but division of powers between the union and the states in terms of all list. The lists are list 1, 2 and 3. List 1 is union list, 2 is state list and 3 is concurrent list. So all these lists are comes under federal system, that is under the schedule 7. Next is Schedule 8. Schedule 8 consists of official languages. Now, there are 22 languages recognized by the Constitution. Before, it was only 14 languages. And these all 22 languages comes under official languages. And these are all official languages and this comes under Schedule 8. Some languages are added later. They are Sindhi. Sindhi language added by the 21st Amendment Act of 1967. And Konkani, Manipuri and Nepali languages by the 71st Amendment Act of 1992. So, Sindhi language is added by the 21st Amendment Act of 1967. Konkani, Manipuri and Nepali languages are added by the 71st Amendment Act of 1992. Bodo, Dogri, Maithili and Santhali by the 22nd Amendment Act of 2003. So in the year 2003, by the 92nd Amendment Act of Indian Constitution, Bodo, Dogri, Maithili and Santhali added to our Constitution. So, all these 22 languages are comes under Schedule 8. Next one is Schedule 9, Land Reforms. Acts and regulations of the state legislatures dealing with land reforms and abolition of zamindari system and of the Parliament dealing with other matters. This schedule was added by the first amendment in 1951. Land reforms means acts and regulations of the state legislatures dealing with land reforms, and here we have abolished the zamindari system and the parliament dealing with the other matters. This schedule was added by the first amendment in 1951 because there were only 8 schedules before and now there are 12 schedules. So the 9th schedule added by the first amendment in the year 1951. Next one is 10th schedule, defection. Provisions relating to the disqualification of the members of the parliament and state legislatures on the ground of defection. So, in case of defection, the parliament can disqualify its members. The provision relating to the disqualification of the members of the parliament and state legislature. This comes under Schedule 10. Next one is Schedule 11, Panchayats. Specifies the powers, authority and responsibilities of panchayats. It has 29 matters. 11th schedule deals with the powers, authority and responsibilities of panchayats. And there is 29 matters. 12th one, municipalities specifies the powers, authority and responsibilities of municipalities. It has 18 matters. 12th schedule deals with the powers, authority and responsibilities of municipalities. And it has 18 matters. These are all 12 schedules. Let's see the 12 schedules once again. T for territories, E for emoluments, A for affirmation, and R for Rajya Sabha, S for scheduled areas, O for other areas, F for federal system, O for official languages, L for land reforms, D for defection, P for panchayats, and M for municipalities. Hope you understood my lesson. Our code is tiers of old PM. Now I will ask you three questions. First question is, which schedule deals with the salary of president? Second one, the schedule which gives provisions for disqualification of members on the ground of defection. Third one, the schedule which deals with Rajya Sabha. So, if you understood the video, please like, subscribe the channel, press bell icon to get all the notifications and share to your friends. Thank you.